Virtual production is a buzzword in the industry these days. We've seen a huge uptick in the adoption of these techniques in recent years, and the demand is only increasing.
Wow!
If you're a producer, you've probably been hungry for information about how all of this works. The goal of this module is to dive into some of the specifics of planning for virtual production, so you can make an informed decision about if these techniques are a good fit for your next project. You probably have some questions, like, how much does virtual production actually cost? How much time is it going to take to execute these techniques effectively? And who do we need to bring on to the crew in order to make all of this happen? Let's begin with everyone's favorite subject. Using virtual production techniques usually means a reallocation of resources in both where you spend it and when you spend it.
Pero podía pasar algo, ahí se puede abrir una ventana, se puede abrir una puerta, puede entrar un personaje digital. Las técnicas que usamos son muy similares a las que usamos para post-pro, lo único que tienes que tenerlas antes.
The thing about virtual production is that a lot of your costs and the budget are going to come up front, which is, I think, the thing that's the most jarring for producers who are used to kind of peppering those costs throughout, but then it will be amortized over the rest of the production, and then you'll start to see shorter timelines on the shoot.
Virtual production is going to impact each department a little differently. In pre-production, you'll usually need to allocate time, budget, and crew resources for CG content creation, or 2D plate capture. The only exception would be if you're using pre-made digital assets. But even if that is the case, they'll likely require some customization before they're ready to use. You might spend some extra time rigging an LED stage, but ultimately you can reduce travel and practical location costs. And once your footage is in the can, your VFX shots are likely to be less in number, less complex, and overall more efficient. That said, you should always keep a small contingency for any potential VFX fixes. Like any other kind of shoot, things can go wrong on the day.
Cut, let's reset.
Getting bang for your buck in virtual production comes when there's economy of scale. For example, if you have only a couple of simple shots to capture in a simple interior location, it probably doesn't make sense to create a CG version of that. Plus, if you can capture something easily and safely in the real world without breaking the bank, real life is always better. But if you have a lot of locations to go to, or places that are tricky to get access to film in, maybe the weather isn't on your side, or perhaps you have a lot of green screen backgrounds to replace, this could be a tool that helps you out.
Our virtual production sets are all daisy chained in the shooting schedule. We try to bring them into the stage as fast as possible and get them out as fast as possible. We have a total of 30 sets going into the volume and out, filling 30% of the season. Being able to do that all out of Germany, out of Potsdam, Babelsberg, is amazing.
Savings can include reduced transportation costs and company moves, smaller lighting and grip packages, and an overall increase in efficiency of shoot days. Savings in travel can also help contribute to a more sustainable production. When it's all said and done, virtual production doesn't always mean huge budget. So don't discount the idea of virtual production just because you're worried it's going to break the bank. That said, if you go into principal photography planning to wing it, the costs can pile up.
Get ready, because the fur is about to fly.
Let's talk about how to schedule your project effectively. One useful strategy when creating your timeline is to work backwards, starting with the target date for principal photography, and then tracing back on the calendar to figure out when the digital set work needs to start. Make sure to leave enough time in pre-production for LED rigging, creative reviews, and pre-lighting. The first step will be to engage the Netflix virtual production experts. They'll be able to help set your production up for success, depending on your approach. On any VP shoot, there's the soft prep and the hard prep phases. For both phases, you'll want to bring in your heads of department and vendors, for example, ahead of a 2D plate capture shoot or the virtual art department kickoff. This can be anything from 8 weeks to 30 weeks before the shoot day, depending on the amount of assets or scenes to be created and the complexity of them.
Oh my God, that looks so good.
For example, a set of 2D driving plates can be captured as close as 4 to 8 weeks before the shoot, and a fully 3D complex futuristic game engine environment can take up to 12 weeks to create. The final few weeks before the shoot will be devoted to hard prep, building out the stage, dressing the sets, and pre-lighting. This is also when you'll be testing the LEDs, calibrating cameras, and making final refinements before it's time to call.
Action!
Please remember that these timelines are general estimates, and your production may need more or less time depending on the specifics of your scenes.
So Netflix have virtual production experts in pretty much every region who can help our productions with whatever their virtual production endeavor may be, whether that's using an LED volume to film and camera visual effects, do some digital world capture, maybe they want to do some virtual scouting to check out some safety issues. We're here to support our productions if they so choose to use this tool set.
I think it's important to have that flexibility and to be able to adapt to different circumstances, because there's no single recipe for each show.